Springfield Falcons assistant coach Jerry Fleming. What's here with Springfield Falcons assistant coach Jerry Fleming. And Jerry, first question right off the hop. Early part of the season, seven games in. Just your overall recap so far of the first seven games this year.
Oh, a few highs, a few lows. We're guys still trying to find out and learn about each other and then finding the right balance and chemistry together. I think we've gotten off to a few slow starts, especially at the beginning. The good news about that is we found a way to come back late in games, to win games and tie games. So there was a little bit of positive, a little bit of negative, some things we need to work on and some things that we can build upon that we did really well. So a good group of guys. Bottom line is they care and they work hard, and that's always a good thing.
How important is it early in the season to go through some adversity, like Hartford opening night, down 3-0 first period? Do you quickly learn the character that's in that locker room early on, and how important is it to go through that early part of the season?
Well, I think that you're going to go through it throughout the season. There's spurts where you're going to be playing extremely well and things are going to be going your way. And contrary to that, there's going to be points in the season where no matter what you do, you're going to have a tough time finding it and getting in your groove. The good news, like you said, about Hartford and even Providence is we found ways to give up goals at the beginning of the game and fought back. And guys, like I said, the character of guys that illustrate that they can come bounce back and they aren't going to lie down and die speaks volumes for the group of guys that we do have.
Back-to-back games this weekend here against Lowell, home and home series, actually three straight against Lowell. Just talk about that, how important this weekend series is, divisional opponent, pretty much an 8-point swing when you look at it. Just how important is this weekend?
Well, we had their number pretty well last year. Brand new year, brand new team. It's always important to win games in your own division. Here's a team that we may meet down the road that may have playoff implications. So I think it's important for our confidence to come out in the next two games and establish ourselves and build upon the things that we did well last game and things that we've done well throughout the season thus far.
Sure. For yourself, first year as an assistant here in Springfield, just talk about joining the staff here in Springfield and how big of a transition is it from you? 7 years head coach in Florida. How's the transition gone from you from being the head guy in the ECHL now as an assistant here in the AHL and how that's gone for you?
Well, first of all, two great guys to work with, Jeff and Dave, have made a really easy transition for me. Two great guys, learning a lot, just working with them, getting some different ideas on what they like to do and how they approach the game, different philosophies, which can only add to your repertoire. I think the difference between being a head coach and an assistant coach is, as a head coach, you wear so many different hats and you're pulled in so many different directions. Whereas an assistant coach, your primary focus is obviously to help the head coach in whatever roles he sees fit that need to be done. And second of all, you can concentrate on the guys and developing individual skills and working with guys after practice and doing a lot more video with guys and focusing on making them better. So obviously your role changes. It's a role that I'm really enjoying. Like I said, we have a great group of guys two great guys, so it's been a lot of fun, and I'm sure we'll just continue along with that.
Sure. How do you guys as a staff break down the responsibilities with the three coaches? I'm sure fans see you've got the head guy, the two assistants, but just walk us through, even on a practice day here, who does what and how you kind of share the responsibilities as a coaching staff?
That's just it, Damon. It's a shared responsibility. Jeff will set practice together. He'll run some ideas off. Dave and I will bounce ideas off each other, for practice and those type of things. As far as in-game, I think everybody has an input. Obviously, it's Jeff's decision on where he'd like the guys to go, but he allows us to, and bounces ideas off us to interject with some of our own ideas and some of our thoughts and philosophies. And, it's just been a kind of a team effort, and us working together as a team, I think we try to really send that message to the guys that if we're working together as a team to make everybody better, it just follows and sends the message to them that they got to work together as a team.
You've been around the game quite some time now. Who are just some of the coaches that, whether as a player, as a coach, or who are some of the coaches that you played for that may have taken something that they had into your coaching career over the last 7-8 years?
Well, I think I've taken a little bit from every coach that I've had, whether it's good or bad. I think I try to learn from everybody that I come in contact with, and even if they haven't coached me, you read different articles from different people and in different sports, not just in hockey, but I have had the great pleasure of working with some terrific, terrific people, Mike Terry, Pauline Bordeaux, Jacques Lemaire, Dave King, I think that you draw a little bit from each one. You try to take as much as you can, try to absorb as much information as you can, and you mix that in with some of your own beliefs and some of your own philosophies.
off the ice. How's the transition going here in Springfield, and how you enjoy New England compared to Fort Myers?
Actually, it's a beautiful place. You know, my wife and I have had the great fortune of living in some beautiful places, but most importantly, wherever we went, the people have always been A1 and fantastic, and New England is no exception to that at all.
Welcome to New England, welcome to Springfield, and best of luck.
Thanks, Dave.
Falcons assistant coach, Jerry Fleming.